Both warriors are ready, and the stage is set for our first bout of the quarterfinals here on the Wray and Nephew Contender. The first boxer to strut down the walk of pain is looking to inflict some here tonight. He's ready to claim that number one spot with a win for himself and for Team Canada. Make some noise for Dave, Fast and Furious LeBlond.
Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out.
All right, 8 mile thing indeed. Next down is our Jamaican pugilist who stepped up last minute and made weight. He's ready to make the most of this opportunity. He has been through a lot in the last week, and hopefully this marks a new chapter in his life. But he's ready to seize the moment tonight. Give it up for Donovan Police Campbell.
Awesome. Hey, upset. See, I'm upset.
Cut and clear, all crosses, good vibes only was set tonight. We are a few minutes away from seeing just how well these two fighters match up in the ring. But let's go to Patrick Anderson and see how they match up on paper with tonight's tale of the tape.
Thank you very much, Crystal. It's time for the tale of the tape. And one of the important things to look at in this fight tonight, it's youth against experience. LeBlanc is 24 years of age. He's 25 years younger than Campbell. Campbell, you can tick two boxes for the police. He's taller. He has a 5-inch reach advantage. The weight difference is a wash. Campbell has more fights as a professional, though 17 wins, 7 losses, as against 3 wins and 4 losses for LeBlanc. Campbell last fought in August of last year when he had a draw with Fabian Tucker. I think we're in for a very exciting fight tonight. And let's get all the details and the introduction from the ring announcer, Oliver Hardy.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you and welcome to the Chinese Benevolent Association Auditorium, Kingston, Jamaica. As TVJ brings you another night of action-packed boxing sponsored by Wray and Nephew White Overproof Rum, guaranteed full strength. This bout is sanctioned by the Jamaica Boxing Board of Control with our president, Stephen Bomber Jones, and our vice presidents, Alexander Johnson and Lieutenant Colonel Derek Robinson. Our judges at ringside are Clifford Brown, Lindell Allen, and Donovan Boucher. Our timekeepers are Valerie Murphy and Kemar Duncan, and our doctor at ringside, Dr. Andre McDonald and his short time team. Okay, boxing fans, here we go with our main event of the evening. 5 rounds of boxing in a welterweight matchup. And now, for the hundreds in attendance and the millions joining us around Jamaica, live from the CBA, it's the Wray and Nephew Contender! Introducing to you first, boxing out of the blue corner, representing Canada by way of Quebec, Canada, wearing black trunks. He weighed in at 147 pounds. He has a professional record of 3 wins, 4 losses. Dave, Fast and Furious LeBlanc. And his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the red corner, representing Jamaica by way of Kingston, Jamaica, wearing black trunks with silver trim. He weighed in at 147 pounds. He has a professional record of 17 wins, 7 losses, 2 draws, 4 big wins coming by way of knockout. Donovan Police Campbell. And our third man in the ring, our referee, Owen Nelson.
One of gentlemen, the most improved referees, perhaps, with the exception of Ian Jardine, our top referee in the country, Owen Nelson, in charge, issuing the final instructions to Donovan Police Campbell on your left and Dave LeBlanc on the right. He will be telling them, keep the punches up, that's above the belt. Watch your heads and no holding. And remember all the rules. When I say break, you break. And to protect yourselves at all times. 5 rounds of boxing, quarterfinals of the Wray and Nephew Contender Series, Season 8, the opening quarterfinal contest. The winner here will be guaranteed a minimum of $200,000 after this contest tonight. The judges are Clifford Brown, Lindell Allen, and Canadian Donovan Boucher. So we're just about to set for the opening bell, and here we go. Everybody knows Dave LeBlanc by now. There can be no surprises. He's fast. Michael Gardner had said who is supposed to have been in the ring tonight, but virtually disqualified for failing to make the weight, came in at 4 pounds over, 151, 152 pounds. The limit here is 147 pounds at the upper limit. The lower limit is 140 pounds, a 7-pound range. You can't be lighter than 140 pounds when you ought not to be heavier than 147 pounds. Police is taking some unnecessary punishment to the body that can break you down. Hasn't been in the ring since August of last year and looks a little bit off. His timing will be off. No matter how much work you do in the gym, when you get into the ring, it will be a totally different affair. He's tough. He's really a journeyman, 49 years of age. On the male side, the equivalent of our Alicia Slick Ashley. Still fighting and one of the best super bantamweight female boxers in the world, even at age 50. LeBlanc is 24, he's 25 years younger. So he has that natural advantage of youth. He has some ability. And so Police taking this fight, as he said in the interview 29 hours ago, he has his work cut out here. And all the early work is being done by LeBlanc. And so far with a minute to go, would be winning this round. It's the 10-point must system. The winner is allotted 10 points, the loser of the round 9. If you beat up your opponent, then you could score it a 10-8 round. If you knock your opponent down, usually it's a 10-8 round. Campbell is taking a lot of punishment. He's tough. I just think his timing is off. And LeBlanc is beating him to the punch. 30 seconds to go in the opening round. And this will be a huge round for LeBlanc. Send his confidence soaring. Campbell has his guard up. And LeBlanc says, thank you, I will go body hunting instead. Less than 10 seconds in the opening round. And that's a big round for Dave LeBlanc.